Hi everyone, my name is Stephanie, and this is what's new to the Edge Developer Tools in version 96. In version 96, there's a new experiment with the Developer Tools user interface available for preview. The console can once again appear in the top and bottom panels. The Sources tool now notifies you when source maps can't be loaded. Selecting the drop-down triangle icon in the DevTools UI now opens the menu. Opening source files in VS Code now integrates better with the Sources tool. And the Microsoft Edge DevTools for Visual Studio Code extension now features a dockable screencast, device emulation, and live inline issue reporting. First up, the Microsoft Edge DevTools team is experimenting with a new Browser Developer Tools UI that provides a vertical action bar for all of your tools, a quick view to have two tools open simultaneously, and several customization and organization options to personalize your tools. Select the gear icon to open settings, navigate to the experiment section, and select the focus mode experiment to give this new UI a try in Microsoft Edge version 96. The team is eager to hear your feedback about the new DevTools UI, but please note that because this is an experiment, the UI may change and evolve in future versions of Microsoft Edge. With the focus mode experiment turned on, send us your feedback by tweeting at @EdgeDevTools or by selecting the help icon and then feedback at the bottom of the activity bar. Next, since Edge version 87, you were able to move any tool between the top and bottom panels. However, we heard from developers that moving the console tool repeatedly was cumbersome. As of version 96, the default experience for console has been restored, allowing you to quickly switch between a full screen view of console and a split screen view without moving the tool. For those who prefer to have just one console tool, you can configure the behavior of the console. Right-click the console tab in the toolbar, select Configure Console, and deselect Show Console tab in the main panel and drawer. Next, the Sources tool now provides several indications in the UI when DevTools can't load your source maps. In the page view of the Navigator pane in the Sources tool, files that DevTools could not load source maps for have a warning icon in place of the file icon. Selecting a file with the warning icon will open the file in the Sources tool with an info bar indicating that DevTools either could not fetch the source maps correctly from your server or parse the source maps correctly. From the info bar, you can learn more about the issue by selecting the Open in Issues button. The Issues tool will open in the drawer and provide information about how to resolve the issue and get your source map loaded correctly in the DevTools. Next, in earlier versions of Microsoft Edge, selecting the triangle icon in the DevTools UI for opening drop-down menus didn't result in the drop-down menu being displayed. Instead, you had to select the drop-down menu entry itself, and that would display the drop-down menu. Now, in version 96, the issue has been fixed. Selecting the triangle icon for any drop-down menu in the DevTools UI now successfully displays the drop-down menu. Next up, opening source files in VS Code now integrates better with the Sources tool. Previously, turning on the open source files in Visual Studio Code experiment had unexpected behaviors when you were using the existing Sources tool in DevTools. Setting breakpoints would direct you to VS Code or to documentation to configure the experiment correctly. As of version 96, this experiment integrates better with the Sources tool. When the Sources tool has already been displayed, setting breakpoints and opening files will open the Sources tool. Following links to source code from other panels will continue to open in VS Code when the Sources tool is not displayed in the DevTools. And finally, the Microsoft Edge DevTools for Visual Studio Code extension now features a dockable screencast, device emulation, and live inline issue reporting. You can see the web project in its own tab inside the editor and simulate various devices. Instead of finding out about issues in an extra tool, Visual Studio Code highlights them in your source code and reports them live while you create your code. You can read more about the Microsoft Edge DevTools extension for Visual Studio Code at the link in the video description. And that's it for version 96. Don't forget to tweet your feedback about the DevTools to the Developer Tools team at @EdgeDevTools on Twitter, or provide feedback via the feedback tool in the DevTools UI. You can find more information on these features in the What's New documentation linked below. And don't forget to like and subscribe to stay tuned for what's coming next in version 97.